Hello everyone! Today we'll learn how to export a project to a video in ActivePresenter. After spending much time on creating your projects with ActivePresenter, you may want to export them properly. If you want to have a demonstration that does not require user interactions, then video format is a smart choice. This is the project that I have created, and now I will start to export it to video. First of all, open the Export tab, and select Video icon. ActivePresenter will launch the Export to Video window. It has two tabs containing options for your exported videos. First of all, we will work with the General tab. This one contains four big groups of options, which are Rendering options, Video, Audio, and Output options. Under the Rendering section, you can choose which property will be rendered into your exported video. For example, if you select Zoom and Pan, Cursor Path and Export Audio, the exported video will display them. Besides, if you select this one, ActivePresenter will export your project to a video along with a separate subtitle file with SRT extension, so you can edit the font size and color of the substitute or change its language. And if you want closed captions to be hard-coded inside a video, select the checkmarks. In this case, you cannot change any attribute of the closed captions anymore. Once you select the checkbox, your project will be exported to video and embedded in a HTML page to be viewed in a browser. Under the video section, you can change the video properties. Video size lets you change the size of the exported video based on the canvas size that you defined before. Width and height are the width and height of the exported video respectively. They will be automatically calculated whenever you specify the video size and vice versa. Next, set a frame rate between 1 and 30 frames per second. A higher frame rate might increase the video size. The most commonly used range is between 20 to 30 frames per second. Then define the number of frames between which we might have a keyframe in the keyframe box. Finally, define the video quality in the range from 1 to 100. Higher value, better video quality, and larger file size. Now we'll move to the audio options. Firstly, select the audio channel from mono or stereo. In comparison with mono, the stereo channel needs double file size. Then choose sample rate and bit rate from a drop-down list. They define the audio fidelity of your exported video. The higher value, the higher audio quality, and the bigger file size. Now comes the final options of the General tab, which is the Output options. Access the Format drop-down list and choose the format that meets your requirement. As you can see, ActivePresenter allows you to export your projects to multiple video formats. Then specify the file path and name for your video here. Okay, now we get to know the other tab of this window. The Advanced tab contains options for video thumbnail. It's only activated when you choose to embed your video to an HTML page. It allows you to select a slide image in your project or an image on your computer as the video thumbnail. Check None if you don't want to have any thumbnail image. Finally, click OK when you are ready to export your project to a video. And here is the exported video. Let's see.
Circle.
Rectangle. Triangle.
Square.
Alright, that's how to export your projects to videos in ActivePresenter. Thank you for watching.